And action. Welcome to the most boring video of my channel. I just watched Gene Nagata's video where he's talking about how he vlogged for the whole day. And like, nobody has time to watch the whole vlog. I was just watching the video where he's talking about it. And then I watched a few snippets from the whole day vlog. And in his video where he's talking about the vlog, he threw out the challenge for others to do a 24-minute vlog. And at first I was like, ew, that's a terrible idea. Like, that will be so extremely boring. Because like right now it's an afternoon and I'm just doing my Etsy order. So I'm just basically sitting there and knitting. And I know that on my channel, like, longer videos tend to do quite badly. Like, nobody is interested in watching me for 24 minutes. But the more he talked, the more I thought, well, okay, I'll just give it a try for several reasons. First is that although I feel very comfortable on camera, usually I want everything to be very polished and I do a lot of editing and I cut out every awkward poses or stuff that I said wrongly, because English is not my native language, and so I don't always talk as smoothly as I would want, and my pronunciation is off, and then sometimes I just can't remember the right words, or sometimes I just get confused in my head, and so I just like to edit out those little bits. But yes, maybe it would be nice for me to do something a bit less polished, and so I decided to do this challenge. I'll do a 24-minute vlog where I'm vlogging straight. There will be no cuts. It's just one long take on my GoPro Max. And I want to make it as close to my usual, everyday routine that I would do. But also, I just wanted to make it slightly more interesting than usually. Because usually right now, while I'm knitting for my Etsy shop, I would usually just listen to audiobooks or watch YouTube, but this time I'll talk a little bit about what's going on in our lives, what's on with my dogs, and also we'll do today's training in this video, because for today I have not yet trained my dogs, because today we had to do a meetup with workers who will be renovating our house, so we're finally doing that, and oh my god, it's stressing me out so much, because even though I really want to see this house renovated, I really hate that color of the walls. I've hated since the day one. It's terrible. I hate it. I don't know why, but anybody in their sane mind pick peach color for their walls, it's been terrible. But on the other hand, this house is a real mess and I'll need to clean everything out. Here, let me show you. So I just need to clean out every shelf, we need to do the books, need to go into the garage. Those shelves have to go away. We have to clean out everything in the kitchen, because the kitchen will be completely changed. And so this room has to be completely empty for them to start renovating. And oh my god, that will be crazy. Also, right now my dogs are just chilling in their crates. And I put them in the crates because when the workers came, my dogs just want to go and help everybody and be super, super excited and just enjoy interaction, and they want to play and stuff. And that's not very helpful when you have to deal with things. And so I put them in the crates. But Mio had a real hard time on calming down. And so when the workers left, I actually didn't let her out of the crate. I just wanted her to calm down, and now that they're nicely sleeping and they have slept for about an hour or so stuff, I'll just let them out, and then I think we'll actually maybe do the training, and then I'll go back to making my Etsy orders. So first to come out of the crate is always Lamore, because sometimes he's too afraid to come out if like Mio is checking on him or something. So, maybe. And of course they can't come out without the release command. Okay. And now Mio will come out. Where is she? I can't find her on this small screen.
Stop. Love me.
And the reason why Lamora is usually afraid to come out is that Mio always goes in and checks Lamora's like her crate, and so she doesn't like Lamora doesn't enjoy it, and sometimes he just wants to like stay there and I don't know protect his crate. Also, this video might get obnoxiously loud, so yeah. Oh, one nice thing that I want to show you. Right now in kitchen I'm making a broth for my dogs for agility, because this weekend we'll be running agility, and so after each course they get to drink a broth because they need to get their energy back up, and also Mio usually refuses to drink anything, every time I make them broth, and usually I just keep it frozen, but right now I've run out of that, and so I needed to make a new one, and there's just like chicken necks and duck hearts. So okay, let's get to our training. I'll get the treats from the fridge, which is also a terrible mess, and I'm not going to show it to you. Okay, that's weird. I'm almost out of the treats. Oh, here they are. Okay, let's use those. And I'll just put down the camera. And let's try to do something here. Okay, I need to maybe lower it. Yes, that looks to be better. This is a really weird thing to make, like a really weird. Okay, so I'll train my dog separately, and while I train one dog, the other dog will be waiting here on their place. So Mio has decided that she's already good to wait. And so I'll start with Lamore. For Lamore, today I have an idea to train his balance and not to be afraid from like wobbly things, because he's having a lot of problems in agility with seesaw. He doesn't like it when it like tips over and he wants to jump off it. And it's a real pain point for me, because like when I started training him, everything was going so well and we did everything so correctly and he was really great on the seesaw, but like then he spooked himself one time on the agility training. He mistook the seesaw for the dog walk, and so now he doesn't want to go on the seesaw. So we've been trying a lot of things and it's terrible. So right now let's just try to do this. So Mio has to stay in her place, and meanwhile Lamora will have to step on that thing. Yeah, absence. Already doesn't like it. Yes, super! Malatsis! I'm just wondering, like, how much can you see of that thing? Okay, you can see that. Great. Also, I just remembered that I need clicker for this thing, so I'll be right back. Just keep watching my gorgeous dogs. I'm starting to think that this video would go better if it was in wider shot, but I can't change it now. Sorry. Oh, and we're already 10 minutes in. Wow.
Okay, let's try it this way. That wasn't a good click. Okay. Lamora. Super! Молодцы! Super! Ļoti labi. So I just want him to get used to, like, this thing is really wobbly. Here, let me show you. Like, you can't simply step on it, like, it's hard even for me, and so for Lamora, who right now doesn't like wobbly things, it's a bit harder for him, so that's what we are doing, we are building his confidence in order to go to the seesaw. Yeah, super! Also, it's super hard to speak while you're training your dog, because I can't put my clicker in place like at the right moment if I'm trying to also speak to the camera. Super! Super, Lamora! Ļoti labi! Also, I'm starting to think that his paws are really like slipping on the thing, so maybe I'll add like a velvety like fabric to it or something. I'll have to think about it. Mia? Yeah, malatsi. Also, it's really good to see how well Mia is just staying there. What? Super. Okay, let's make this session very short. I'll now try to do the same thing with Mia. Mia, okay. Lamora? Mia? Mia? No. Yeah, super. Lamora, vieta. Yeah, ļoti labi. Mia, nečupki. Mia? Mia doesn't really need it, but like, that won't hurt her. No, super. And also, it would be really nice for her to get on with all four paws. That would be the goal, basically. Yeah, super! Basically, I'm just waiting for her to figure out what I want of her. So she's trying like different things. Super! Lamora, that wasn't allowed. While I'm training one dog, the other dog has to stay in the place. Yeah, now let's just, okay. Come on, okay. So I'll put this thing away for now because I think that's enough for today. And, okay, how much time do we have here? 14 minutes. Oh my god, this is going to be so long. This is the most confusing moment and they want to do the same thing both, but I'm just passing just one. Mia, Mia. Mia. Oops. Stop. So let's just work on me off stage. That's very nice. Sit. Yeah, like that. Lops Lamora. Yeah, ne. Sit. I just want Mia to hold her position. And so this is what we are doing for agility start days. And obviously, like, it's way easier for her to do it right now because there's no action happening around. Okay, yeah.
Also, if you're wondering about the clicker thing, it's like just a small plastic thingy that's making this noise. And it's used in training for marking. Like, marking is a good stuff. Like, when the dog does exactly what I want the dog to do, I'll just click and then treat. And why it's better to use a clicker instead of just giving treats is that you want to mark the exact moment when the thing was done right. And it's way easier to do with a device than just, like, you can't give your dog the treat at the exact moment, or if you're working on, like, some distance stuff, or if you're working on endurance, like, you want to for your dog to have longer start days, then not start days, like, longer stays, longer hold the position, then you're clicking it when you're away, and then you go and give the treat. And now I'll change the dogs again, so Mia will have to wait, and then Lamora will be working on stuff for lure coursing, because recently we discovered that he's not confident enough to take the lure and at the finish of the lure coursing. And so I'm trying to teach him that it's okay, like, to really want it and to really get it. And so that's what we'll try to work on it. Today I don't have the plastic thingy. He destroyed the last one, and now I need to make a new one. So we'll be just doing that with a toy. Okay. Also, now for me it will be harder to stay because I'll be playing with Lamora. Mio came at the toy and Lamora was okay, I won't take it. Mio, wait. Lamora? Yeah, wait. Wait, yeah, malacis. And for Mio, like, the condition for place is she has to lie down, so if she's sitting there, that doesn't count. Mio, stop. Lamora? Yeah, Manda. Yeah, and he switched to the treats. Great. Manda. Yeah, super. Ay, malatsis. I laps Lamora. Yeah, I laps. Yeah, malatsis. Yeah. Okay. Pretty. Okay. That's enough for our training session for today. Oh, it's already 20 minutes. Wow. This is going actually faster than I expected. Now I'm confused. Because I was really expecting for it to be very long and like that I couldn't like decide what to do with all the time and stuff. But it turns out, oh my god, I'm so sorry. The camera isn't as steady as I thought. But it turns out that, well, actually working quite nicely. And so, as usually, now that I have finished working on the, like, now that I'm finished training my dogs, I'll get back to knitting. But also, I just took treats in my hands, so I need to wash hands. Great. Also, wash your hands, always. Not only because, like, you know, the knitting stuff will get dirty, but because you just need to wash your hands. Can you even? Yeah, it doesn't matter. Like, you know how people wash hands, right? It's not that interesting to watch. Okay, this is a weird part. Like, this is a really weird part. You're trying to show something that's like really casual for you, and you're thinking like, who cares? Like, you would never include something like that in an actual vlog. But here we are. So let's get back to the knitting. I have quite a lot of it to do. And also at this time, I'll expect my dogs to calm down more. And mostly they'll just join me on the sofa. But right now, right after the training, I don't know, maybe they'll be more excited or stuff. Don't know. Like, Lamora is still like looking around and watching for treats or maybe toys. Mio has gone to check Lamora's crate. And Lamora is just checking out what's happening in the yard. So, and Mia is just randomly checking out stuff. So, yes. It was way easier to do this while I was training my dogs, but also, like, that's what mostly our training sessions look like. They are just 10, 15, 5 minutes, and we usually work on one or two things while the other dog's waiting. And like, this time I would have gone more, like, I really wanted to continue, but first of all, it's good to like split those training sessions in small parts and to really think about what you're doing. And so now I realize that I need to cover that plasticky thing in some sort of fabric so that my dogs can actually step on it because they're really slippery. But also, if I start making those workout sessions longer, it gets harder for me to really get to them. Like, once I've started them, I don't want to go out of them. But if I'm just sitting on my couch, I'm working on my Etsy orders, or if I'm editing videos for YouTube, I just don't want to like get up and start training my dogs. And so it's the easiest way for me to do that is to just tell myself that, oh well, I'll train my dogs for 5 minutes. Oh, and they are finished. Wow, that went way quicker than I expected. Let me know in the comments how boring exactly this was. And bye from Team Ginger.